21st Precinct, Sergeant Waters. Well, where do you need the emergency squad? Yeah? 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 Well, what's the trouble there? Locked behind a what? Yeah? Yeah?
You're in the muster room at the 21st Precinct, the nerve center. A call is coming through. You will follow the action taken pursuant to that call from this minute until the final report is written in the 124 room at the 21st Precinct.
All right. I'll notify the Communications Bureau. Yeah, that's right. They've got to be notified before the truck and roll.
21st Precinct. It just lines on a map of the city of New York. Most of the 173,000 people wedged into the 9/10 of a square mile between Fifth Avenue and the East River wouldn't know if you asked them that they lived or worked in the 21st. Whether they know it or not, the security of their homes, their persons, and their property is the job of the men of the 21st Precinct.
The 21st, 160 patrolmen, 11 sergeants, and 4 lieutenants, of whom I'm the boss. My name is Kennelly, Frank Kennelly. I'm captain in command of the 21st. I was working my day tour, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., after I had turned out the platoon, I read reports and signed communications for approximately 1 hour until Sector Car Number 3 came by the house to take me on patrol. At 9:25 a.m., we were driving downtown on Fifth Avenue, and as we turned east into 72nd Street, a Signal 30 ambulance responding was broadcast over the radio. As the Signal 30 denotes an armed felony, I instructed the operator, Patrolman Meister, to make the run up the east side to Lower Harlem. When we hit the block, I saw that 2 sector cars and the sergeant's car were on the job. The ambulance had arrived. I got out of my car and went into the building, an old and ill-kept tenement. Patrolman Vaccaro, who had been posted inside the hall at the front entrance, told me the trouble was on the fourth floor, that a man had stabbed his wife. I started up the stairs.
Who's that coming up?
Captain Kennelly.
Oh, hello, Captain.
Sergeant, is Vaccaro down at the bottom, Captain?
Yes, he's there.
Vaccaro! Ring in for a medical examiner.
What was that, Sergeant?
Ring in for a medical examiner.
Yes, sir.
Right
away.
She's dead, hmm?
Yes, sir.
That's what the ambulance attendant says. In the rear there.
You got the husband?
No, sir, he was gone. My mother's in there. She lived with him.
What does she say?
Go ahead.
Thanks.
She speaks nothing but Spanish.
Oh.
That's the mother.
Where's the body? In the bedroom?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Lieutenant King.
He really did a job, Captain.
You see this over here?
Yeah, he sure did.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Matt.
Oh, hello, Captain.
What happened?
We don't know exactly, sir. Would you like to help me out with the mother?
Yeah, sure.
Maybe we can find out something.
All right, I'll try, man.
We got the name from the super, and that's about all we know. Dead woman's name is Alfonsina Maria Cotea.
Mm-hmm.
Mother's name is Torque. Didn't know the first name. Husband is Bernardo.
Captain?
Hello, Captain.
Ziegler? Ryan?
First call came over as a family.
The husband did it?
Yes, sir. That's what it looks like.
Fit?
Yes, sir.
Any idea where he went?
No, sir. If he's smart, it'll be pretty far.
Yes, sir, Lieutenant?
You come with us. The captain's going to help us talk to the mother.
Yes,
Sergeant Waters.
Yes, sir. Right here, Lieutenant.
We're going to talk to the mother. Did the first officer on the job get the ambulance attendant's name?
I'll find out.
We'll be in there. Let me know.
Yes, sir.
You poverty keeps on me.
Okay, Captain.
All right. ¿Qué dice, señor?
Pobre Alfonsina.
Sentimos mucho lo que pasó y comprendemos cómo usted se siente, pero tenemos que hacerle algunas preguntas.
Sí. Sí, trataré. Trataré si usted lo desea.
Muchas gracias. ¿Cómo se llama la muchacha ahí dentro?
Es mi hija, Alfonsina Marina.
Her daughter, all right. Alfonsina Maria.
Tan linda. Era tan linda.
¿Qué es su nombre, casada?
¿El nombre de su marido?
Sí, eso es.
Pues, está casada con Bernardo Cotella. Me vino a casa en toda la noche. Vino borracho. Se dijo que ella salía con otro
hombre. Wait a minute. No tan deprisa. Yo no hablo el español muy bien. También. The husband's name is Bernardo Cotella.
Yes, I checked with what the super said.
¿Quién la cucheó?
Bernardo. Bernardo lo hizo.
She says the husband did it. ¿Usted se lo vio hacer?
Sí. Yo estaba aquí mismo, en este mismo cuarto. Entró en el cuarto y dijo que...
No, la gringa se da. Calma, calma, por favor. Queremos coger todo bien. ¿Qué está haciendo?
Does she know where he went, Captain?
¿Cómo se llama usted?
¿Cómo me llamo yo?
Sí.
Señora Chispa Torque.
Señora Torque, ¿sabe usted a dónde fue Bernardo?
¿Bernardo?
Sí.
No lo sé. Salió. Mató a Alfonsina. Yo tenía miedo que me matara a mí también. Solamente salió. No lo sé. Tenía miedo, mucho miedo.
Sí, entendido. She doesn't have any idea where he went.
Yeah,
but the tenant is
terrible.
Oh,
thanks, Sergeant.
Well, I'll try and find out how it happened.
Yes.
Señora Torque, ¿puede decirnos exactamente lo que pasó?
¿Lo que pasó?
Exactamente lo que pasó. Desde el principio y muy despacio para que pueda comprender.
Sí. Trataré.
Despacio.
Sí. Pues... Bernardo no vino a casa anoche.
Her husband was out all night.
Eso ha pasado a menudo.
Not the first time.
Alfonsina y yo nos acostamos. Él no estaba aquí cuando nos despertamos esta mañana.
He wasn't home when he got up.
Por fin regresó. Estaba muy borracho.
¿A qué hora?
A las 9, poco más o menos.
He came home very drunk about 9 o'clock this morning.
Alfonsina quería saber en dónde había estado. Empezaron a discutir una
discusión enorme. There was an argument.
Estaba muy borracho. Ella gastaba todo su dinero, él dijo.
Very drunk. Accused her of wasting his money.
Él dijo que no había vuelto en toda la noche porque ella salía con otro.
The husband accused her of running with other men.
Pero mi Alfonsina nunca salía con otros hombres. No desde que casó.
Deje eso por un momento. Quédese con la discusión.
Ah, sí. Bueno... Sacó una navaja grande de ese bolsillo y la tiró en el suelo.
Just a second, espere. No la entiendo. ¿De dónde sacó la navaja?
De su bolsillo. Sacó la navaja de su bolsillo.
Claro.
La tiró en el suelo.
Bueno, llegaremos a eso. He had a knife with him. Took it out of his pocket. ¿Qué clase de navaja era?
Una navaja grande. Así de larga.
¿Se abría?
Sí, se abría. Así de larga.
It was a switchblade, man.
Oh, we didn't find it, Captain. Can you ask if she knows what he did with it?
Sure. Señora Torque, ¿sabe lo que hizo con la navaja?
¿Con la navaja?
Sí. ¿Qué hizo con ella?
Entró en la cocina y la lavó. Y la volvió a poner en su bolsillo.
He washed it off and put it back in his pocket. I'll see if I can find out where she was doing all of this.
Yes, sir. That'd be a good idea.
Señora Torque, ¿qué hacía usted cuando él atacó a su hija?
Yo estaba aquí.
She was here in the kitchen.
Entré. Traté de ayudarla.
You're trying to help her?
Pero ella gritaba y él estaba borracho. Y yo tenía mucho miedo, mucho
bueno,
miedo.
Bueno,
no sé.
Esperé un momento.
Sí, bueno. Será
she said she was very frightened.
No sé lo que voy a hacer.
He was in the kitchen, heard her daughter scream. She ran in and tried to help her, but she was afraid he'd kill her, too. Bueno, ¿a dónde fue cuando salió?
Afuera. Solo salió corriendo.
¿Por la puerta?
Por la puerta, sí.
See you in a minute, Sergeant.
All
right.
He says he just ran out, man.
I pulled you down
out the door.
I don't mean to hear come up.
Captain, would you ask if he made an attack on her, if he threatened her anyway?
Yes, sir. Señora Torque, ¿le atacó a usted con la navaja su hijo político?
Dijo que me fuera, que era su mujer.
¿Pero le atacó o amenazó?
Dijo que me mataría si no me fuera.
¿Él dijo eso?
Sí, él dijo eso.
He says he threatened to kill her, too, if she didn't get out of the room.
Tenía miedo, mucho miedo.
Yes, Sergeant.
Can I see you out here in the hall, man?
Yeah, all right.
Fit. Yes, sir. You stay here with Mr. Torque. Yes, sir.
Donde van los
policías? I'm sorry. I don't get it.
What is it, Sergeant?
Vaquero's got some information, sir.
In connection with this case, Vaquero?
Yes, sir. This is Leroy Clifford. Young, how do you do?
Hello.
What kind of information is it, Vaquero?
Well, I was standing downstairs where the sergeant posted me. This fellow walked up to me and told me he knew where Bernardo Cotella was, the husband.
You know where he is right now?
Yes, sir. A few minutes ago.
Where is he?
In a bar and grill.
Where?
Over there on Lexington Avenue.
Where on Lexington? What number?
Well, I couldn't tell you the number, but I could show you the place.
Are you sure it's the same Bernardo Cotillo who lives here?
Yes, sir.
Well, what makes you so sure?
Well, I see him every day. We work at the same restaurant. We ride downtown on the bus sometimes. And I've been up here to the house for a beer a couple of times. Well, it's too bad about her. Too bad.
What do you do at the restaurant?
Well, I'm the fry cook.
And Bernardo?
He's a bus boy.
How'd you happen to see him in the bar and grill?
Well, I was just walking by now. I looked in the window. I knew he had to be to work, so I went in and I said, come on, Bernardo, we ride downtown on the bus together. Well, he was about two-thirds in the bag, and I thought it wasn't going to do any good, so I said, you ought to go on home, Bernardo. Get sobered up.
What did he say?
Said he couldn't go home. Said he was in big trouble. He wanted to borrow money. He's very tight with money. He said the cops were after him. Said he had a gun and a nice bolt, so they weren't going to get him.
Did you see either of them?
No, sir. He always talked like that when he had a few drinks. So I told him he wasn't going to work. I was. I came out of there and walked over to the bus stop. I saw the big crowd, people in front of here. Somebody told me what happened. Well, I thought maybe I'd better tell somebody. So I walked right up to this policeman, didn't I?
That's right.
And I told you.
Will you come back over there and point him out to us, Leroy?
Yes, if you want. I just don't want to be late for the job.
We'll take care of that, Leroy.
He didn't tell you anything about what he planned to do or where he was going?
No, sir, but from the condition he was in, I don't think he's going far.
Well, he's been a pretty long way already.
Leaving the others in charge at the scene of the homicide, Lieutenant King, Detective Fitzpatrick, Sergeant Waters, Patrolman Vaccaro, and I took Leroy Purford and in two cars drove to the bar and grill on Lexington Avenue where he said he had seen the husband of the murdered woman. Because of the possibility that Bernardo Cotella had a gun as well as a knife, the others in uniform and I stayed out of sight on the sidewalk while Lieutenant King, Detective Fitzpatrick, and Purford walked by the window of the place.
Well, see him in there, Leroy?
No, sir.
All I see is the bartender.
That's all I see, too. He was in there.
He's not now.
Well, did you see him, Matt?
No, sir.
I didn't see anybody but the bartender.
Maybe he's in a booth.
Well, maybe, Captain. We couldn't see in the booth walking in that direction. Let's go back the other way.
That's okay with me.
Sid.
Yes, sir?
You wait here this time.
Yes.
Okay, Leroy. Can you see in the booth?
Yes, I can see. There's nobody in any of them.
Are you sure this is the place?
Oh, yes, this is the place.
Is he in there, Lieutenant?
No.
That's the place, Sergeant. That's where he was.
All right, Leroy, let's go in and talk to the bartender.
Lieutenant.
Yeah?
Well, if it's all the same to you, I'd just as soon not get involved.
Leroy, from the second you walked up to that cop and told him you saw Bernardo, you've been involved.
Well, I guess I can't argue with that.
Seth, how do you know that bartender?
Oh, just to say hello.
You ever patronize the place?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yes, sir, Lieutenant?
We don't see him in there, Fitz. We're going in and talk to the bartender.
Yes, sir.
You wait here, Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
He wasn't there. Hasn't been 20 minutes.
All right. Go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, gentlemen. That's the room. Oh, hello, Leroy.
Hello, Gabe.
We're police officers. You the owner here?
Me? No, I just work here. The bartender.
What's your name?
What's the trouble, Leroy? Did something happen?
What's your name?
Protea. Gabriel Protea.
Do you remember Leroy being in here a little while ago?
Sure. I remember him being in here. What's the trouble?
Was there someone else in here at the time?
Yeah, there was someone else. Bernardo.
See?
Bernardo Cotella.
Where'd he go?
He didn't go no place. He's back there in the washroom.
There?
Yeah, there.
The door's open.
What's the trouble?
Leave that door open. Open up. Open up, Bernardo. Open the door. Bernardo.
Go away. Go away from there.
We're police officers. Unlock that door and come out here.
You go away from here.
Come on. Got no time to play around.
You go away. I warn you.
Okay, Fitz, kick it in.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Hey, what are you doing with the
somebody. I'm a responsible.
Stand back over there.
But listen,
just
you
stand
can't...
back. How about it, Bernardo? Bernardo. Okay, Fitz.
Get away!
Stop. You all right?
I told you had a gun. I told you.
I'm okay, Lieutenant. Get over there in the booth, Leroy. Over there.
I just as soon get out of here altogether.
Just stay there. You'll be all right.
What's the matter? Where's the trouble?
Second. Sit. Yes, sir. Go on and tell the captain and them.
Yes, sir. Right away, Lieutenant.
Bernardo, what do you think shooting's going to get you? You're not going anyplace.
You manager, you're risking your life. I stay right here.
But he drunk far around the door.
He did more than that. He killed his wife.
Him?
That's right.
That nice gun? Hey, Bernardo.
All right, just let him alone.
Crazy fool, I thought something was the matter. Drunk in the morning before breakfast, almost.
Back here, Captain.
Asked to buy my razor and shave. Shave in a saloon. You should have known something was crazy.
All right. Stay away from the front of that door.
Yes,
sir. Look at the hole that one made in the door, Captain.
Yeah,
I heard it whiz by me. Bernardo? What do you say? Bernardo?
Go away. Go away from there.
Crazy, Ben, crazy.
You get out of here. Get behind the bar.
Don't worry. Twice.
What do you think, man? Yeah, it beats me. We can't work on the door without him taking a pot shot at it. Is there a window in there? I never thought of it. Sit, stay here.
Yes,
sir. I doubt if there's much of a one. Not in a building like this. Gabe. Bartender.
Here I am.
All right, you can stand up. He can't hit you from there.
With my luck, the bullets could go around the corner.
Is there a window in the washroom?
Yeah, a little one. It's big.
Could he get through it?
It's got bars. Bars like a jail. To keep our thieves. No, he couldn't.
Where does it lead to?
To no place. To an air shaft.
Bernardo.
Just up to the roof? Is that the only place?
That's the only place.
How many stories is this building?
Four.
Bernardo.
Four stories. He couldn't get out there anyway. The bars. Stick on.
Matt, we ought to get an emergency truck
come
up here. Might not be a bad idea, Captain. With their axes and crowbars, they can work on the door and stay out of the line of fire at the same time.
The boss wouldn't like it to break the door.
What do you want to do, have a cop killed to save the door?
Sergeant?
Yes, sir.
Come here.
Crazy guy, I could have told you something was wrong. Plain crazy.
Yes, sir, Captain.
Look, go on out to your car and call in for an emergency truck.
Yes, sir.
Tell them to send a truck, not a car. We need the equipment they carry to work on that door.
Right away, Captain.
Bernardo.
Loco, plain loco.
Come on, now.
Okay, Lucado. Stay posted at the door.
Yes, sir.
Keep them out. There's nothing to see, folks. Just keep moving. Car 681 is settled, okay? At 3321 Lexington Avenue, the bar and grill.
At 3321 Lexington,
okay? Right. 3321. An armed fugitive has locked himself in the washroom. Send the emergency truck, okay?
You need any additional assistance?
Okay. Just a truck. We got 5 men on the job, okay?
Come on.
All right, keep moving, folks. Better get out there, Vaquero.
Yes, sir.
Keep the sidewalk clear.
Yes, sir.
Now, look, Bernardo. What do you think this is
going
to get you?
Sergeant. Yeah, Leroy.
Do they still want me to stay in the booth?
Well, who tells you to stay there?
The lieutenant. Bernardo.
Well, you'd better stay.
But I'm losing time on the job.
All right, get back there. Get around that way.
Yes, sir.
We don't want any dead heroes here. Emergency truck's on the way, Captain.
Good.
Emergency truck is on the way, Matt.
Okay, we can use them.
Bernardo. Bernardo, open that door and come out here.
No. I won't come out. I won't.
Anybody want to drink a whiskey? Whiskey's on the house.
Save it, Gabe. Bernardo, let's cut out the kidding. Open the door and come out.
No, I won't.
Watch it.
I won't come out.
Well, that's four, Captain.
Yeah.
Well, he's only got two more.
Unless he has an automatic or a pocket full of shells.
Yes, sir.
Captain.
Yeah?
Coming over.
What if we got his mother-in-law over here to talk to him?
No, she'd get hysterical.
You don't think she could talk him out?
Wouldn't do any good.
This is what comes with desperation. It's the idea.
Wait a minute. Ask him if he knows his wife is dead. Maybe that'll have some effect on him.
Yes, it might. Bernardo! Bernardo!
Stay back there.
I'm not going out! Not me!
You know what we want you for, don't you?
I know. I know what.
Did you know that they killed her? She's dead.
I was Tina. I did.
Yeah, you did.
I didn't mean it. I didn't.
You did, though.
I only want to think of an effort. Not to go out with other men. To spend my money.
You killed her.
No. No, I didn't want to. She knows I didn't want to. I know her. I know Uncle Tina. Who said she's dead? The doctor.
Yeah, that's right. The doctor.
He's the doctor's boss. He let her die. I didn't mean it.
Now, come on out and we'll talk about it, Bernardo.
No! No, I won't come out! I don't believe you!
Brother, I had an idea he was convinced. I guess the only thing to do is wait and break it in.
Yeah, I guess so, man.
Got a cigarette on you? I'm out.
Yeah, sure.
That's the emergency truck, Captain.
Yeah, man. Thanks.
Yeah, go on out and meet him, Sergeant. Tell him what we need in here.
Yes, sir. We need plenty.
It's all right. I've got matches.
Captain.
Yeah, Fitz.
Could I have one of those two, please?
Sure. Catch.
Thanks.
Want a light?
Yes, sir.
Coming over.
Much light.
Bernardo. Bernardo.
No, don't ask me. I'm not coming out.
How many bullets you got left in the gun?
You think I'm crazy. Why should I tell you?
The answer to the first question is yes.
Yeah. No, we'll send a couple of men from the truck up to the roof and let them go down the air shaft with a line.
I don't know. That might give Bernardo a pot shot at them.
No, we'll see what it looks like.
Okay, in effect. I'll watch it now. Back there in the washroom.
Over here, come on. Over on this side.
All right. Take it easy, Jed. No hurry.
All right, hold it there. You two with the axes, can you work on this side?
Sure. Yes, yes.
Okay, come on. You with the crowbar.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Over there.
Over here, come on.
Situation is, he's got a gun in there. Do your work. Stay out of the line of fire.
Matt.
Yes, sir?
Let me talk to him once more.
You know how much good talk is going to do, Captain?
Well, I can't do any harm.
No, sir. Can't. Go ahead.
Bernardo.
No, I don't come out.
Quiero decirle algún, Bernardo.
¿Quién es?
Escúcheme. Hay hombres afuera con hachas. Van a romper la puerta.
¡Se matarán, se matarán!
Solo quiero decir que si rompen la puerta, usted tendrá que pagarla.
¿Yo?
Sí, usted.
¿Cuándo?
Por lo menos $50.
¿$50?
Y que sí. Abra.
And open the door.
Throw that gun out. And the knife. Throw the knife out, too. All right. Now come out yourself.
I didn't mean it. I didn't mean to kill it.
Adam. All right. Come here.
Hold still, Leroy.
You told me to wait in the booth.
Oh, yeah. Well, you can go on now.
Has the detective got your address?
Oh yes, sir. He's going to alibi me. Goodbye, Captain.
So long. And thank you.
Oh, the boss is going to ask me where I thought of this.
All right, you man. You can get back on the job.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, you going to the station house, man?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
What did you say that made him open up?
Nothing important. Just that if we broke down the door, he'd have to pay for it.
Why are you first briefing Sergeant Waters? What kind of accident? Yeah? Yeah? Yeah. Where? Yeah? Was anyone hurt? Was it hit and run or head on? How was it head on there?
And so it goes. Around the clock, through the week, every day, every year. A police precinct in the city of New York is a flesh and blood merry-go-round. Anyone can catch the brass ring. Or the brass ring can catch anyone.
21st Precinct, a factual account of the way the police work in the world's largest city, is presented with the official cooperation of the Patrolmen's Benevolent Association, an organization of more than 20,000 members of the Police Department, City of New York. Everett Sloan in the role of Captain Kennelly, Ken Lynch as Lieutenant King. Featured in tonight's cast were Bryna Rayburn, Santos Ortega, P.J. Sidney, Harold Stone, Ralph Camargo, and Bill Quinn. Written and directed by Stanley Niss. Produced for CBS Radio by John Ives. Art Hanna speaking.